So hello guys, welcome back. In this video, we are going to learn how to create custom list view in Android application. So this video is the continuation of previous video where we have learned how to create a simple list view. So in this video, we will extend that topic and learn how to add images along with the text view and give it a custom lock. So if you are new to our channel, then it is a request to please subscribe to our channel because we have been bringing a lot of free courses, material and content for you. So stay tuned and watch the video till the end. So guys, creating custom list view consists of following steps. So we will follow all these steps and have a successful custom list view at the end of this video. So first of all, we will have to drag list view in the main activity. So let's start the session. So let's create a new project. From here, click on empty activity and click next. And from here, give the name as custom list view. And we are okay with the package name, location and language, and click finish button. Let's wait a while until Android Studio is ready for the development. So okay guys, our Android Studio is ready. So first of all, let's create a list view. So from the layout, go to the activity main XML file. And from here, delete the text view which is already present. And from the legacy, currently the list view is resided in the legacy. And from here, select and drag list view onto our desired activity. And from the attributes, give the constraints. And now go into the code mode. So you can see here our list view has constraints with respect to the parent. And from here we have to declare its ID so that we can access it in the code. So guys, our first step is completed. So now we have to declare another activity which will consist of the UI of our one row, the image and the text. Let's do it. For this, click on layout. From new, go to the activity and from here select empty activity and name it as custom list view and click finish button. So our custom list view.xml file is added. From the code, let's delete this constraint view and replace it with the linear layout. Now we have to design the UI of a row. In this way, we have an image and then text. So let's create the image first. Height and width will be 100 dp each. And we have to declare its ID as image icon. Now it's time to declare a text view. And declare its ID as text view and set its gravity to the center so that it may look in the center, and its text size, give it text as so guys, the UI for the cell of list view is completed. So we have successfully completed our second steps. We have created a custom activity and add UI elements. Now our third step is create custom adapter. But before that, go to the main activity file and from here we have to add two strings array, the fruit name as we are displaying here, the fruit name and the image. So we have declared the strings for fruit names. Now we have to declare another array consisting of the images. But before that, we have to import that images into our project. So for this, I have these images with the same name. Copy these images and click on drawable, right click on it and paste it here. Click OK. So all our images has been added here. In the same way, we will have to declare the array of images. So guys, we have successfully declared two arrays. Now it's time to add the custom adapter here. We will declare the base adapter. In the previous video, we have declared array adapter, which was simple, but this UI is somewhat little complex. So we will have to declare a base adapter. So right click on the Java folder, from here click on Java class, and from here we will declare custom base adapter. Click on the class and press enter. Now we will have to extend it as a base adapter. We are receiving an error. Click on it and implement methods. So it is mandatory to add methods for this interface. Click OK. Now we will have to make its constructor. Let me declare some public variable here. So here we have the public list fruit and public list images and inflator. And we will import these lists from our main activity and declare this public variable with imported list. So let's do it. So we have to inflate that layout inflator from this context. This context will be received from this main activity, and it is mandatory. Now from the get count, we will return the count of our fruit list. So it means that the rows will be equal to the count of list fruits. For the moment, leave get item as it is. And from the get view, we will have to design our view and return it. So guys, when the custom list will be populated, this callback method will return a view for each row. Means for each row, it will design this view and return to the list. And the returned view will appear in the rows. So here we have initialized the view with our custom list view. So in the same way, we have accessed text view and fruit images. And we have set the text of text view with our array list. And the indexed is the position of each row. Means if I'm going to receive the position for position 0, I will get the text as Apple and the image of Apple. And it will be returned here. So after designing our view, we will return it. So our step of creating the adapter, create custom adapter, is completed. Now we will have to set the adapter data to our list view. For this, we will have to go to the main activity file. And from here, we will have to declare the list view. Now we have declared the list view and we will allocate the adapter with our custom adapter. But before that, let me initialize the custom base adapter. So we will have to import the context of this activity and list of names and images to this custom adapter as we have declared in its constructor. Now let's set this adapter to our custom list view. So guys, we have successfully completed this step. Let's build and compile the application. Let's see how it looks like. So guys, we are seeing the images along with its name on the right hand side. So when I'm going to click on this, I can see here my selection. So now let's customize it. For this, we will have to go to the activity XML file, and from here we will have to declare its divider. Let's set the divider as black. Divider is basically the boundary between each item or each row. Let's declare its height 2dp, and in the same way let's declare its selection, and in the same way let's make the font size of text bigger to look it better. Now let's build the application again. So now you can see here there is a black boundary or divider here and its height is 2dp, and we are seeing the text somewhat bigger. So when I'm going to select on it, I can see here the selection which I have declared the purple color for my selection. So now let's come towards the last step, that is on click event, so that when a user click on a particular row, we will get the click event for this. For this, I will have to go to the main activity, and from here I will have to set on item click listener and adapter view dot on item click listener, and here I will print a log here. So we have print a log here that when a particular item at a particular position is clicked, we will receive its callback along with its position. Now let's build and compile the application again. And before that, let me pull out the logcat. And from here, when I'm going to click on this apple, I am receiving a callback, item is clicked at position 0. In the same way, I can test it along with each position, because the position starts from the zero index and go towards the four steps. So guys, hope you have enjoyed the video. This is enough for this session. See you in next video.